So we're going to start in Genesis, what chapter? One. Genesis 1:1, huh?
It's a chapter.
Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. This is where we're going to be today. So Livy and Hallie, those of you with your Bible, you're going to go to almost the very first page. It's going to be right towards the beginning. All right? So here's what it says. Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. So in the very beginning of time, to humanity, okay, because God is not bound by time. God has always been. The Bible says, I am the Alpha, the Omega, the first and the last. He's the beginning and the end. So humans are bound by time, but God is not. So when we talk about in the beginning, we're talking about the beginning of creation, okay? What humans know as earth and time. Nothing existed except for God. God was around. And he created the heavens and the earth. The earth had no shape, and darkness covered the earth. Close your eyes tight. There was total darkness. Total darkness. Open your eyes. The Spirit of God was there, but there wasn't anything yet on the earth. The earth wasn't made yet. So what I want you to remember is that God didn't start being God when earth was made. God existed before the earth was made. And so one day, on the first day, God said, let there be light. And so if we look in Genesis 1:3, it says, and God said, let there be light. And there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. So what did God make on the first day?
Earth and heaven and night.
Well, so earth was starting to be made, but it says in the Bible, it says, and God said, let there be light. He made the light. So I'm going to do box number one, but then I'm going to have y'all help me. So on day one, there was darkness, right? Darkness covered the whole earth. So there was darkness. And then he said,
let there be light.
Let there be light. And so then there was light. So on the first day, God created the light. He called the light day. Good job. All right. The next day, I'm going to let someone else go over there and draw a picture. So be ready. Okay. What did God say after he made the light? Did you hear it? He said, and God saw that the light was
good.
You're going to hear that. And it was very good. He was pleased with it. All right, here we go. Day two, Genesis 1:6. And God said, let there be an expanse in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters. And God made the expanse and separated the waters that were under the expanse from the waters that were above the expanse. And it was so. And God called the expanse heaven, and there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. On the second day, boys and girls, God made the sky and the sea. He divided, a division between both. So up high was the sky. Sometimes you hear the sky referred as the heavens, okay? It's not particularly talking about God's home heaven. Sometimes when people say the heavens, they just mean the sky. So God divided the sky from the waters. So he made the sky and the water. So who would like to go draw something there? You're going to draw what he made. Let's see, Braun. Go give it a try. So there's crayons on the bottom. And in box number two, show us, because he divided it. So how can you show us he divided the sky from the water? What could you draw? Let's see. Perfect. Awesome. Ooh, I love the detail. Very good. So let this help you guys remember the order. So we have the sky and the water. Very good. And he's coloring it in. All right, let's review. Day one, God made the light. Darkness. Well, he didn't make the darkness because darkness already existed. He made the light. Day two, what did he make?
The sky.
The sky and the waters. Very good. All right, Braun, you can keep doing your illustration, okay? And we're going to go. Now he's adding some sky. Very nice. All right, here we go. Down, what day are we on now?
Three.
Day three. Genesis 1. Genesis chapter 1, verse 11. And God said, let the earth sprout vegetation plants, yielding seed, each according to its kind, and the earth. And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed according to their own kinds, and trees bearing fruit in which is their seed, each according to its kind. And God saw that it was
good.
And there was evening, and there was morning, the third day. And I skipped the verse above on accident. Verse 9, it says, let the waters under the heavens be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear. So on the third day, God saw the waters, and he said, let there be dry land. So now we have grass, and mountains, and hills, and valleys. Is there still water?
Yes.
But now God has put dry land. And what did he put on the dry land? Don't say animals yet. Did you hear?
Plants,
vegetation. And the plants that he put on the land were fruit-bearing plants. If it's fruit-bearing, what does that mean? If it's fruit-bearing, Lily? Right. It would produce fruit. So the plants would help, you know, provide food that eventually man would need to eat, right? And and other animals. All right. So, Lily, would you like to draw in box number three? What are we going to draw there, Lily?
Grass
and plants. You could even draw a little lake there because there is still water. So I'm going to let her draw away while we go on to the next one, okay? On day one, God made the
earth.
He made the earth, but the light. Use the boxes. On day two, God made the
water
in the sky. On day three, God made the
land.
The dry land
and
the plants. Here we go. All right, chapter 1, verse 14. And God said, let there be lights in the expanse of the heavens to separate the day from the night, and let them be signs and for seasons and for days and years, and let them be lights in the expanse of the heavens to give light upon the earth. And it was so. And God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. And God set them in the expanse of the heavens to give light on the earth. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. What do you think was the light to rule the day? What light do we have in the sky that rules the daytime? Livy?
The sun.
What is the light in the sky that rules the night? Aiden?
The moon.
The moon and the stars, right?
The sun is actually so bright it blots out all the other stars shining. That's why we can't see them during the daytime.
Right. And when the sun sets, we can see all of those things. Right. Just because we don't see the stars don't mean they're not there, right? Very good. I love learning about space. I think NASA and everything about space is so interesting. I like astronomy. I think outer space, anything about that is so cool. All right. So on day four, God made the sun, the moon, the stars. Who wants to draw that? I saw Kaylin's hand first. Then I'm going to get a boy over there again. All right. So we got the sun, the moon, and the stars on day four. All right. Let's go to day five. We're getting towards the end. And God said, let the waters swarm with swarms of living creatures. And let birds fly above the earth across the expanse of the heavens. So God created the great sea creatures and every living creature that moves with which the waters swarm according to their kinds and every winged bird according to its kind. And God saw that it was
good.
And God blessed them. Listen, this is important. God gives really the birds and the fish a command. Be fruitful and multiply and fill the waters in the seas and let the birds multiply the earth. He tells and wants the birds and fish to make more birds and fish to fill and populate the sky and the waters. He wanted the fish and birds to have babies so that there would be more and more. And there was evening and there was morning, the fifth day. So what did God make on day five? Joe?
Animals.
Well, not all of them. He didn't make all the animals.
He made the birds and the fish.
Right. Let the waters swarm with swarms of living creatures. And what animals live in water?
Fish.
Okay. Fish. And let the birds fly above the earth. So animals that were winged, they had wings. The other animals are coming. But on day five, God made the birds and the fish. One of my boys, would you like to draw the birds and fish? Joe? All right. Joe, in number five, you're going to draw birds and fish. Okay, birds and fish. Don't draw a giraffe yet and those things. Birds and fish. Okay, here we go. We're on day number six. And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures according to their kinds, livestock and creeping things and beasts of the earth according to their kinds. And it was so. And God made the beasts of the earth according to their kinds and the livestock according to their kinds and everything that creeps on the ground according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. He made all the other land animals and all the other animals that you can think of. When I count to three, yell out an animal God made. One, two, three. So many. He made animals. So on day six, God made animals. All the other animals you can name, God made those. So who wants to draw animals? You can draw multiple animals. Jacob, go for it. Draw multiple animals, different kinds, okay? Give us a variety. We got frogs and snakes and otters and penguins and all kinds. Giraffes and zebras and llamas and sheep. There were so many. All right. And then there was something else God made on day six, but we're going to pick up at that next week. ¶¶
In the beginning, nothing existed except for God. God created the heavens and the earth. The earth had no shape, and darkness covered the earth. The Spirit of God was there, hovering over the waters. God spoke, "Let there be light." What God said happened. God saw that the light was good, and He separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and He called the darkness night. Evening came, and then morning came. That was the first day. God spoke again, "Let there be a space between the waters to separate them." What God said happened. He made a space between the water that was on the earth and the water above the earth. God called the space sky. Evening came, and then morning came. That was the second day. God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into one place, and let the dry land appear." What God said happened. God called the dry land earth, and He called the gathered water seas. God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the earth make plants and trees with fruits and seeds." What God said happened. Plants and trees grew according to their kinds, and God saw that it was good. Evening came, and then morning came. That was the third day. Next, God placed lights in the sky. God created the sun to shine during the day and the moon and stars to shine at night. God gave us lights to shine on the earth to separate day from night and to help us track time in days and years. God saw that it was good. Evening came and then morning came. That was the fourth day. Next, God made creatures that move and swim in the water. He made birds to flap their wings and soar across the sky. God saw that it was good. God told the animals to multiply, and they filled the seas and the sky. Evening came and then morning came. That was the fifth day. Then God made more animals, livestock, creatures that crawl, and wildlife to live on the earth according to their kinds. When God said it, it happened. And God saw that all of it was good. Jesus is Lord over all of creation. The Son has always existed. The Bible says everything was created by Him and for Him, and He holds everything together. All of creation exists to bring God glory.